is all things, all the address, buildings, plot, buildings and floor and unit should handle in geographically. But no, exactly we can see those information. And then after that, those information you can use anywhere. And maybe police can use it for the security reason. Maybe the fire service can use this security reason for this information geographically. And maybe transportation sectors or maybe banking or insurance company provider, they need those information where exactly geographically their customer or their service is distributed. That's why this is important nowadays. Any application, whatever it is application for the self-driving car, as application for the automatic car parking or traffic transportation, as like application for the banking or insurance, or even application for the smart city. Everything, everywhere, the nowadays there is no application. It is the most important part is the geo part. Everything needs to be visualized or presented or analyzed in geographically. That's the important one. That's why it takes really long time to prepare such a developments or such a presentations. I need to do last 2 months and hard job to be implement those implementation. That's really helpful for you and even though for me to share with you. So here this is the GIS data, the digitization applications. We did the JavaScript implement functionalities, and just you can digitize it and put it your information here and then copy paste, even though you can put it in buttons and send to this data into the your forms, your HTML forms or even though JSP forms or whatever it is in the view technology. You can put it here and then you save information and then digitize it. So this is the digitizer functions and just based on the open layer JavaScript library. So just digitize it, click it and put it the information and that's all, and you give it the necessary information where it's stored information and located this one. So here is the one example that how can we visualize our data to the OpenStreetMap. This is one of the example without using any geo server. So if you have a data, you plot it in the data in the as like longitude, latitude, orientations. You see that the list and there is a lot of coordinates. So it have every polygon has a closing, a first point, a last point is the same, then closing. And if you using the open layer, then you can do this way. And this is the installation. How can I will show you detail when I did the development exactly this way. How you can explain it here. So this is another visualization. If you are leaflet, you can even though you can build it like them one pop-up, like when you click one of the buildings or plots and then even the floors, and then you see the register information, how the detailed information, even though picture of the floor plans and in plot plans or building plans is possible to do this information. This is most important, the clear. I will show you how it's done. And this is the end presentation of the application. So you see that all the actions like user registration actions, user role, address, plot, buildings, and the register address information in the map portal and plot portal and building portal and so on and so forth. And then this stage, we didn't did the implementation for the floor and units. Maybe in the future, we can, when I have enough time, I will do this one. So exactly how the, and even though we can integrate the 3D models based on the information that we have it in the systems. So here the presentation of the informations, like this is informations from the Bangladesh in Dhaka city, like mega city, and this information we just put it our information to the OpenStreetMap to the our spatial database, and we call the service and build a overlap it to this with Google Maps with Google Hybrid Map View. Even though we have a lot of possibility, maybe Yahoo Maps or Bing Maps, what do you like to do? That's one. Depending, it's like your business strategy or your business plans. And he's the one of the view for the OpenStreetMaps and the like different maps map category. Like here is the Street View, Google Street View category, and here is the satellite view category, satellite view with the same data, same informations, and then here is the terrain maps. So terrain maps, maybe you have the sums, saw the sum controls and where the height distribution, and then you can see the you can make more plans. Okay, how the transportation, how we have more efficiently do this the modeling part. For the ways, if you have the height information from the maps, and even though height information from your entries by your records or from your database. You see, here is the general overview how the geometry works, and this I try to give it to you some theoretical background. So points, you see the points, how the point is stored in the first is longitude and latitude points, and this is line string. You see the line string is there, and that's one of the examples. And the polygons, you see the polygons at least 3 points we need to build, at least the four minimum, because opening and closing, and you see the opening and closing same, and then the polygon is like, and then you can say inside the polygon there is a hole, and then even though that's kind of we can manage it, that's the complexity. So multi-point polygons you can do this way, and multi-string lines, and this is multi-string lines, and the multi-polygons, and the multi-polygons, and the syntax of the one of the example is this is only 2D shape, even though you can build it like 3D. If the end customer needed 3D, there is a complexity, but even though we can handle those complexity. So he's as a presentation like a well-known binary and text format. That's and then his example, some geometry like points, real life geometry, the geo point from the Dhaka city, and points, line string, polygon, multi-polygon, and geometry. And this is the example, this one. So here's the providers. You see there are a lot of providers nowadays that the geo formats is there. So if you have a GeoJSON and GeoJSON format is there. If you are working with the shape files, and this is the shape formats, and there is additional file format is there. So basically this is the important one, that if you are working with the GML, group of markup languages, and the extension GML, and then KML, GML, KMLZ, that means the height information. And if you're working with GPS, real-time devices, and then you can go this way. If you are the Microsoft Word or C# one, then the BAT files, and this is the OpenStreetMaps 5 OSM files, and then digital line graphs and DLL files, and this is the open source consortium, OJC, and the WKT and WKB. So this is the important one, because this is the standard for all of them. Even though if you have a data in this format, or you convert or transform this data as a WKT or WKB, and then you can go any tools of any provider support this format. So you see the data sources, the geo data sources and map sources. I will show you detail what's the functionalities, what's the difference between the maps providers, and what's the extension, what the functionalities, which maps has to be, which map source you need to use, but depending on how your applications, which the focus of your application, the basic goals of your applications. So basically for this case, I normally use the both combination of OpenStreetMaps and the Google Maps, the part of the open source part. If you are really enterprise application, then you need to take the Google Map license, or even though Yahoo Maps and then MapQt, also best solution, Bing Map from the Microsoft, you can go this way. I will show you detail of the mesh maps and how the functionality existing there, how the APIs look like that way. So you see that I try to give it to really short description about the maps. In the last screenshot we discussed about the providers, and then the providers and the information, what the APIs is available for the developments. So if you are working with the Bing Maps and then with the C and Visual Basic applications, and then query, there is a query API, there is a geo data APIs and data source management API, geocoding workflow APIs. And if you are working with the Yahoo Maps, and the Yahoo have is a service like geocoding API, map API, and many more. And if you are working with the MapQuest, then there's a direction API, open direction API, data management API, static map API, search API, geocoding API, traffic API. That's I say that depending what's the main focus of your functionalities or your applications. If you are working really traffic systems, then you need to use such a maps and then the APIs to build your traffic systems. I will show you how was it. OpenStreet Maps and Google Maps API. So it depends which level you are. If you are open source level, there is a constraint or the limitations. And if you are in the enterprise level or you have a license, real license from the providers, and you have no constraint, then you can do what you like to do into your applications. And here's some functionalities from the Geospatial.